So, my name is Morgan Russell. We are here inside the Chipped Cup. I am a barista here at the Chipped Cup.
We are located in Harlem, in Hamilton Heights, on Broadway between 148th and 149th. We are a specialty coffee shop. We're a third wave coffee shop that does second wave things, which basically means we use microfoam, we do latte art. Our general thing is that we want to make people happy and give them what they want, and we do our best to make sure that we're giving them the best version of that thing.
So the basic principle of latte art is that you have coffee, you have espresso, a thick, dense liquid, then you've got milk that you steam. When you steam milk for a latte art, you don't want the milk to be too dry and frothy. You don't want like a traditional cappuccino with like mounds of that dry foam sitting on top. That's not gonna get you good latte art. So what you're looking for is what's called microfoam. So you're looking for a really nice sheen where it's totally the same texture the whole way through, and it's got this sheen on top that looks like wet paint. And then when you are pouring, you start pouring from up high, a couple inches, and the milk from up here can pierce through and mix in with the espresso. And then once you've got it full about diagonally up to here, you bring your pitcher down, because once you get it up close, the milk sits on top of the coffee. So you start up high to mix it together, you bring it down low to get it to sit on top, and at that point you sort of tilt both together and then lift and pull through. And that's gonna create the sort of base for most of your latte art designs. Yeah. Let's see it. When you steam, you're looking to create a really nice whirlpool with the milk. Yeah. So I'm tapping it just to get the bubbles out. I'm gonna pour a little bit out because I got a little extra. And that'll just help me at the end when I'm looking to make the latte art. So high, down low, up and through. And there we go, that's just a nice, clean heart. That, or some variation on that, is gonna pretty much be what's repeated for most of the symmetrical designs that you see pretty frequently, which include a heart, a rosetta, which is the nice leaf, and the tulip. Those are the things that you see most frequently. Those are the symmetrical sort of baseline designs. This is a rosetta, so start up high. Wiggle back and forth, and pull through. this one, we're basically going to do the start to a heart a whole bunch of times and just push through. There we go. There are asymmetrical types. There are all kinds of asymmetrical types that people can do. I've been practicing my swan recently, so I'll show you that one. And people's reactions are always so fun, you know? They get so excited, especially for things that they have never seen before. Yeah, they're just so happy, and that's fantastic.